Latest on that shocking road rage incident here in New York City. You have no doubt seen the video of the SUV swarmed by bikers and then that high-speed chase through the streets. Well, this morning, two men have been arrested. The authorities are searching for another. And ABC's Lindsay Janis has the latest on this fast-developing story.
This morning, police have charged the man seen here punching this black Range Rover with reckless endangerment. Moments later, investigators say Alan Edwards dragged 33-year-old banker Alexian Leon out of the SUV, beating him in front of his wife and young child. That alleged assault, not caught on camera, was the end of a terrifying chain of events that police say started minutes earlier with a different biker. Watch as 28-year-old Christopher Cruz, also facing charges of reckless endangerment, suddenly slows down, causing Leon to hit him. Within seconds, that menacing scene, nearly 30 bikers swarm the SUV. Police say some of them slashing its tires. Then this. Leon apparently panics and makes a break for it, running over 32-year-old biker Edwin Mieses, who is also an aspiring rapper. This morning, the father of two is in critical condition.
All his ribs are broken. His spine is broken in two places. And he's never gonna walk. Never gonna walk again.
With Mieses on the ground, the enraged bikers chase Leon for a terrifying 3 miles before cornering him and eventually assaulting him. Police now say they're looking into Leon's conduct, even though they believe he did feel threatened.
I think there's no easy answer. You have to use common sense. Obviously, if you can get out of there without hurting anybody, that's what we advise you to do.
This morning, we know the group of bikers calls itself Hollywood Stunts and has posted similar videos on YouTube before, like this one from 2011 that ends in another attack.
Well, police say they had prepared for the group's annual trip to New York, deploying additional officers to monitor them. Still, the NYPD says it received 200 calls on Sunday about the group riding recklessly, including a 911 call from Leanne before that accident, telling dispatchers they were driving erratically.
Okay, Lindsay, thank you. We're going to bring in ABC's chief legal affairs anchor, Dan Abrams. And Dan, this is disturbing on so many different levels. And we heard from the mother of the biker who was seriously injured, and the family wants to press charges. Is there a possibility that the driver will be charged?
So there are two issues. Number one is criminal. Number two is a possible civil case. On the criminal front, it sure sounds like the authorities are not going to charge him. Why? The legal standard is, did he reasonably believe that he was in danger when this happened? And when you listen to the way Ray Kelly, the police commissioner, is talking, it sounds like they believe it was reasonable. They're going to continue the investigation, but I don't think that there will be charges filed against him. Now, civil, which is the family's ability to sue him, I think that is almost certainly something that will happen because that's just an opportunity for the family to go after him as opposed to the government.
Will the severity of his injuries play into it at all?
It plays into a potential civil case when you're talking about damages. But, you know, a lot of people are saying, wait a second, on the one hand, you have someone here who is paralyzed, and on the other hand, you have someone who just, you know, was sort of beaten up. Why wouldn't the person who was paralyzed be the sort of the bigger player here? The answer is, it doesn't really matter as a legal matter who was injured more. It matters what was going on in the mind of the individuals who were doing it when it happened.
But what about the bikers? We heard how Lindsay said just there at the end how many calls came in. We've seen the video. That can't bode well for them at all.
No, that's going to sort of weigh into the police's decision. But remember, you got to charge people based on individual actions. You can't just say, well, there was a group that did this last year, and therefore we're going to sort of charge the group this year. Could be different individuals in that group.
A lot of people are anxious to see what's going to unfold here.
Absolutely.
It's developing. All right. Thank you, Dan.